This is the Weeylite Ninja 200. Wow, this light surprised me in a really good way. As I've been trying to build out my studio, I've been acquiring some different lights, and this one really surprised me at how bright it is for its small little size. This is fantastic. I'm moving towards some more specialized tools for size, convenience, and portability. I already have the Weeylite Ninja 400 and several lights from GVM, and each has their own strengths and functions in my different setups. I love the form factor, brightness, and elegance of my Weeylite Ninja 400, which is actually to my left here. And so I was excited to buy its younger brother, the Ninja 200, for my portable needs. Starting with the construction, I'm loving the robust, high-quality construction of the Weeylite Ninja series. The Ninja 400 was a tough, solidly built light that confidently handled a large 60-inch Neewer softbox. The Ninja 200 feels equally confident with its included softbox, though admittedly it's not nearly as big. On that subject, the mount is a mini Bowens mount, not a full standard-size Bowens mount. That's not a problem, as the included softbox works well enough for my on-the-go needs, and it's a great little softbox with two layers of diffusion, and it's quick and easy to assemble, unlike my big Neewer 60-inch. This thing is a snap just to get together. Literally, it's literally snaps together. It's fantastic. I like that the controller is built into the back of the light, so I don't need to worry about an extra brick or controller dangling along the wire if I do use it corded. But of course, I also have the option to use a battery mount, which I'll talk about in a second. Likewise, that brick for the AC-DC adapter is located at the wall, so it's just a thin cable that runs to the light, and it's actually quite long, so no reason that you'd get tripped up or anything like that. Like I said, no need to worry about dangling controllers or big inline bricks. It's really convenient in that way. The best part is the fact that it includes two NPAF 970 batteries and a mount plate that attaches directly to the light, so you can hook two batteries right here and it'll go right in and power the light. It works really well, super convenient. You don't have to be tethered to anything. The plate has a really bright little display. It shows the battery levels and a DC output to connect the light directly. It also has a switch for in and out, meaning that you can change between charging mode and discharging mode to power the light. Also, the plate does not indicate when the batteries are charging, so the percentage just slowly goes up. So don't be surprised if you see no indication when you connect a battery charger. I really can't tell you how pleased I am with the setup. It's really compact. It makes it easy for on-the-go or remote work. It works so convenient. You don't have to carry all sorts of lights and other power sources. This is a one-stop shop for that. One quirk that I found is that the batteries continue to power the status screen and will discharge while the light is off. So you want to make sure you pop them out of that plate when you're not using it. Otherwise, it'll drain it down. Actually, I had that problem, which is why you'll see I'll use one battery of a different size because I had inadvertently drained the other one down. Intensity can be controlled from 1% to 100%, and color temperature can be controlled from 2800 to 8200 Kelvin in 100 Kelvin increments. That's a really wide range of color temperature. It's really nice to have that flexibility. Control the light with the included remote or with an app that's also downloadable. I always get a little nervous, again, using an app that you don't install through the App Store, but I haven't had any trouble. You scan a QR code, it takes you to download link, and it gives you the APK where you can install it directly. Now that I have the Ninja 400 and the Ninja 200, I might find myself using the app or the remote a little bit more than I would have if I just had the one light. For brightness, it's rated at 15,400 lux at 1 meter. What they specify at 5,500 Kelvin. It's a bright little light. It's quite intense, especially in that form factor. It's really, really quite impressive. This light really packs a punch for its size, but it's not quite as bright as the Weeylite Ninja 400, which is rated at a 16,700 lux, so not a ton brighter according to the rating system. That said, to my eyes, I do think the Ninja 400 looks a little bit brighter to me, but still, this has a really high quality 95 plus CRI index, and it looks really good. I've purchased a lot of lights over the last few months, and really there's a lot of options on the market. As I've been outfitting my studio, I've really had a chance to see what options are out there, and I'm really impressed with the value and quality that Weeylite continues to put out. This is a fantastic little light. It's I think it's a big innovation by having this battery pack that can connect and you don't have to be stuck with cords. I think that's really, really nice, and I think that's a great innovation and it makes it a lot easier to work with. I do see myself using this light a lot, and I really can't recommend it enough. Highly recommend this light. With that, thanks for watching this review. If you have any questions at all, put them down in the comments. This is not a sponsored video. I'm happy to answer anything you can throw at me. So, thanks.